And, you know, interestingly, last night, celebrities got involved in this. Richard Gere coming to lead a demonstration along with the Archbishop Desmond Tutu. And according to Richard Gere, he believes this whole issue of the human rights violations that are alleged in the area of Tibet in China wouldn't be even be an issue if it weren't for the Chinese government pushing the envelope of wanting to take the Olympic torch right in to the heart of the lion that is Tibet. Take a listen.
I think if they had not closed up Everest, decided to run through Tibet, this probably wouldn't have happened. I think it was a very foolish and insensitive move on their part.
Now, regardless, the whole end result is what is expected to be a significant demonstration here in San Francisco again later on today. Again, you can see the show of force behind me, the San Francisco Police Department here. Hundreds of uniformed police officers are on scene here because of the tens of thousands of people expected to come down to the streets. As we've said all morning, they are preparing for the worst case scenario, and that would be someone trying to repeat the events of this week in London and in Paris, when individuals tried to snuff out the Olympic torch there. That is something they are definitely preparing for here, because as we pointed out, if it can happen in Paris and it can happen in London, it can happen here in San Francisco. It's something they're prepared for. They hope it doesn't happen, but they are prepared. Live in San Francisco, across from the Ferry Building, I'm Mike Tissell. Chris, Deirdre, back to you.
Mike, what's the ratio, would you say, just out in the area where you are, of supporters and protesters?
Well, you know, right here, it is definitely a pro-supporter rally area. A lot of Chinese flags mixed with a lot of United States flags. A lot of people here talking about how much of an honor and how great this moment is. However, at the same time, especially right across from the Ferry Building, as people are walking to and from, we see them, we're seeing confrontations, one-on-one, face-to-face confrontations starting, where the debate comes. It's not, you know, necessarily any vitriol at this point. It is simply the debate between what's really going on in China. Obviously, those who are here in support at this spot say the truth is that there's no human rights violations, but there are those who are coming saying that clearly there are human rights violations happening and they need to stop, and that is why they are here today, to use that Olympic torch as a symbol of the need to get that message out.
Mike, thanks.